Good afternoon. I'm Dr. Jeff Dailey, the executor of the estate of Dr. Ronald Cross. Very happy to see you all here today. When Dr. Cross died several months ago, he did not leave any blood relations. His family consisted of the many friends and colleagues he accumulated over the years, especially from Wagner College and from here at St. Paul's St. Louis Lutheran Church, where he was music director for over 40 years. It's a pleasure to return here for again for another event in remembrance of Dr. Cross, and I want to thank the church and its leadership for allowing today's concert to happen. It is especially appropriate to be here, inasmuch in the Lutheran tradition, all music praises God. I'm very glad to hear that the church has just engaged a new music director and hope that he will also be here for many decades. I'm also happy to see the memorial plaque so prominently displayed. When the definitive history of early music on Staten Island is written, three names will be prominent. Victor Matfelt, the specialist in the works of the Reformation-era printer Georg Rau, came to what was then Richmond College after being one of the founders of the Boston Camerata. William Monocle of Bay Street, who's sitting in the back row, maker and restorer of string instruments, continues to be one of the world's premier luthiers. And Ronald Cross, whose work on the Renaissance composer Matthaeus Pipelare has never been superseded. Shortly after coming to Wagner College in 1968, Dr. Cross started the Collegium Musicum there. And for the next 20 years, this group provided a laboratory for student musicians to learn the intricacies of medieval and Renaissance performance practice. But Dr. Cross's work at Wagner College extended beyond the student body. He brought performances to churches, schools, hospitals, and nursing homes, and the concerts he gave, both with the Collegium and on his own, were learning experiences in their own right. As he introduced music from the 17th century and earlier to students, parents, friends, and colleagues. An even wider outreach took place in the 1970s when he arranged for the New York Consort of Viols, then as now the nation's premier viola da gamba ensemble, to give summer workshops at Wagner College for some years. These classes attracted students from across the country. Public concerts were integral parts of these workshops, and I fondly remember many of them, even after many years have passed. I remember a work for viols and electronic tape by the Turkish composer Blumenthal, Rameau's magnificent cantata en patience, a baritone trio by Haydn, and wonderful dances from Elizabethan England. These performances featured the incredible performances of Judith Davidoff, the concert's artistic director, and it is due to her kindness that today's memorial concert is taking place. But before we begin, I'd like to make some announcements. First, today's concert is being recorded as part of a project to put online the works of people already. Second, I would like you all to know that the final interment of Dr. Cross's remains will take place on Sunday, September 22nd, in the Columbarium at the Park Avenue Christian Church in Manhattan. If you're not already on the email list that I've been using to notify people about events, then please write your name and email address on an index card in the back of the church so that I can send in the details. Thirdly, many have asked about making donations in memory of Dr. Cross. He was a supporter of many charities, and a donation to any organization that supports music or nature would be appropriate, as would donations to this church. But I'm also happy to announce the formation of the Ronald Cross Memorial Performance Trust, which will be a nonprofit organization which will support musical performances in his name. I'm just in the beginning stages of working out the details of this new endeavor, but I encourage you to let me know of your interest by again writing it down on an index card. And now it's time for music. After the concert, there will be a reception downstairs, thanks to members of the church for arranging that. It will be a time for reflection and remembrance, a remarkable life well lived. Thank you.
Thank you.